warm welcome to the third lecture of the Southeast Asia Lecture Hall. I am Roswana Begum from Singapore University of Social Sciences and truly humbled and pleased to be the moderator for this lecture with President Jose Ramos Horta. The Southeast Asia Lecture Hall is a free, independent, people-to-people program that aims to provide free and regular access to Southeast Asian students and lecturers to world-class lectures from various fields of study. Foreign Policy Community of Indonesia has partnered with various universities across Southeast Asia. We would like to thank our partners from across the region. Today marks our third lecture in this lecture hall series. We are very honored and blessed to have President Jose Ramos Horta.
Good morning, everybody participating in this dialogue. And as we start, I wish to thank my good friend Dino Jalal and the whole people in the foreign policy community of Indonesia for once again inviting me to be a part of this wonderful initiative. And that is a result not only of the national leaders, because national leaders come and go, particularly those who are elected. You change every 4 years, 5 years, or maximum maybe 10 years. So much depends on the role of youth leaders. You have a great role in that to build peace in your communities, in your country. Local leaders, you know, village leaders, and regional leaders, and then academia, intellectual, academics, professors, school teachers. And when I mention religious, I mean every religion, not only Muslims, Catholic, Protestant, all other religions, Buddhists, Hindus. Because that's the only way. There are no shortcuts to peace. There are no miracles, no easy answers. And it required patience. It required time. There are no shortcuts. Countries that want to invest in peace, in long-lasting peace, have to think long-term. So I talk mostly from my heart and the head, imagining that I'm talking to mostly youth across Asia, across the world, who have signed in to this great initiative.
So first, I would like to thank Southeast Asian Lecture Hall for this wonderful opportunity, and President Ramos Horta for gracing us with his presence and sharing us his knowledge about these studies.
Hi, I'm Ben from Singapore. Firstly, I would like to thank President Jose for the insightful sharing. I have a question with regards to ASEAN losing its centrality. I'd like to ask, is it due to a weak common identity? If it is, should ASEAN develop common approach instead of just focusing on common position? Or are there any strategies to strengthen ASEAN in the development of a common identity? Thank you.
So, President Jose, there's a question from a participant from Indonesia who's asking us, if I'm not mistaken, there were mentions of lack of cooperation within the region when it comes to
people. I am from Cambodia, and then growing in a society that the gap between the young and the old is still a little bit big.
And with that, I would like to end this question and also thank President Jose Ramos again for his time, and for all the students, you know, all the very best. And I hope that you would continue to, you know, take on an active role in playing a part in wanting to build peace within the region and globally as well.